Welcome back to my channel, friends. Today I am going to mosaic decoupage on this big size platter. So this is actually an MDF platter of size 6 inches by 6 inches, and this is just perfect for your centerpiece decor, your wall decor. You can even just add up a hook and use this as your wall frame, or you can even use this as your platter base, and this works perfectly. So I have decided to do decoupage mosaic technique with these pattern papers. Now these are really beautiful pattern paper, and I need to choose a design which I can use with on my base. So as you can see, it has so many nice and vibrant colors and beautiful shades, but I'm looking for something which is more generic kind of thing, and I'm not sure which one to pick because I actually love this green shade, but I also love this one too. Maybe I'll go ahead with this one. I'll take up these brown papers, this I'll take up this brown paper and I'm going to use this. And there are many variations of mosaic decoupage what you can do, but here I thought of creating my own paper, my own mosaic pieces. Like you get some really nice cool marble pieces, the bits pieces in the market. Now to start with, I'm just getting the center portion of this paper, and okay, so what I've decided is that I'm going to do the mosaic technique with the circular pattern. So here, first I'm going to make a circle. I just need to pop my scale up. Okay, now here I'm taking up, I'm making this circle. So this is going to be my center circle here. Yeah, so here I'm using this as my center circle. Then I'm going to make good 2-3 rounds so that I can cut it into smaller pieces. Now this is really fun. So when I actually planned for doing this video, I had actually got some nice marble pieces, but then I thought no, maybe I should get something or make something of my own, which will be really interesting and which will be easier for all of you out there to create of your own. So I guess that's the most amazing part of doing mosaic decoupage. Like if you check my videos, I've done a mosaic decoupage with the print, the regular print papers. Then I've done mosaic decoupage with decoupage tissue, which was really a fun one, and it looked actually beautiful, really beautiful. So now if I put it here, I think it is going to cover most of the areas, but I just need to add one more layer. So if you are realizing, I have not picked up the sizes of a very specific thing. Like all these are just the random sizes. I am not at all particular about having this for of a complete one size. And now I need to get my center, and I'll just do, okay, maybe I can just do my marking just like this. I hope you all can see my pencil marking. I'm not sure, because actually I'm doing very faint cutting work, and I'll just mark it with the pencil so that I know which area is half. And I'm just joining all my lines with the dots, which is the center part of my paper, and I'm getting approximately the center piece, and which is absolutely fine, because I guess that's the beauty of your mosaic papers, that they don't have to be exactly exactly the center, and the pieces don't have to be the exact size. Now this is how I have planned it. Now I'm going to cut these areas, and I need to be really careful because I need to make sure that everything, maybe I'll just take another scissor, I'll keep this aside. Okay, now how I'm going to cut is this way. So I've started with my first circle. I'm not going to cut everything at one go because then it will be really difficult for me to manage all the pieces. Wait, just let me just get one more better scissor. Okay, so here is my favorite scissor, which I am using really nowadays. I'm using this scissor a lot and I'm loving this one. So here I'm done with my first cutting work. Okay, now I just feel that maybe I should have or maybe I can have it as it is. Okay, I'll keep it as it is, and then I'm going to have my second layer. And now I'm going to cut my second circle, and I'm just cutting along the lines, and this way I'm going to cut all the papers, like all the lines, and I'm going to have all the strips ready so that immediately I can just cut and I can use it. So here my circle cutting work is done, and I'm going to keep this aside, and now I need to start prepping up my base, and for that I'm using my chalk paint. So here I'm using a nice baby pink shade, and this is actually a flamingo punch, and I'm going to use this on my complete platter. And this is such an amazing shade of a chalk paint. I absolutely love this one. And I'm not going to save my color here because I really want my platter to have a really, really nice chalk paint effect. And this color is so soft, so pastel, which is actually going to add a little bit of contrast to my papers. Now, and whenever you're doing a mosaic work, you just need to make sure that whatever shades you are using, they contrast with your mosaic pattern paper, or the decoupage paper, or the napkin, or the prints, whatever you are using, because it highlights your work a little more, which is actually very, very, very good for you. So maybe I could have chosen white also, that would have also looked really nice, but I wanted to add some more colors to my palette, and I love colors. I love different shades, and I love using them on my platters and my projects. So that's the reason I thought that having some nice color would really, really add a good charm to my project. So here I'm using my sponge dauber, and you know me that I absolutely absolutely love sponge dauber. They don't leave any marks, and that's the best part. That is something which I really, really, really like. And this is done. So my paint has not dried out. My first layer has not dried out, but still I'm just dabbing my color, and you can see that I have a good nice two layers of color on my palette, and you can easily make out with the one layer or the two layers, and they look good. They look really, really good, and they definitely add so much of nice vibrance to your color base, and that's really, really important. Okay, now with the same sponge dauber, I'm going to add the colors on the sides. You can use a paintbrush for the small areas, but as you know that sponge dauber already takes so much of color in it, so I'm just using that. I'm dabbing these sponge daubers only so that all the extra color which is there on my sponge can be brought back to this. Now I will be using my heat gun to speed up the drying process, cause that is really, really important for me so that I can do a video quickly, and I don't have to wait for so much of time, and especially making a video in one go makes your work really, really easy. I'll be adding some more color here, just drops of color. So once the chalk paints dry out, they are completely matte, which is the best part. And I love the matte finish. That's the reason I always use matte finish Mod Podge. I've never used glossy Mod Podge because somehow I was never really fascinated with the glossy effect. But then yes, I have got something new in my craft room, and I really want to try that, and hopefully I'll be trying that really, really, really soon. And if you are new to my channel, please do make sure that you check the description box below. I list up all the material what I've used in this tutorial in the description box with the links so that you can buy them directly, and which is fun for you too. Okay, so here I am done. Again, I'm going to use my heat gun. Never ever just use your heat gun on one area, cause you need to keep moving. You really need to keep moving with your heat gun so that it does not ruin your base. Now my front side has dried out. It's time to color my back side, and I'm going to do it immediately so that later on I can finish my project at one go. So this will actually save my lot of time. I'm not afraid to die. has dried out completely. This is looking really nice and I'm loving this pink shade. And now it's time to stick my papers, and for this I have already done the cutting work and the marking work on the back side. So now what I'm going to do is I am going to cut these paper strips and use it. So I'm just going to cut it one by one, and I just need to be a little careful that I cut it properly. I don't overdo the cutting work, and of course I'm going to stick it. Now the fun part is, for sticking this I have something new today on my table, which is already there, but I really don't know if you can see, if you can see that. So let me just finish this cutting work. So first I need to mark it with a pencil, my center part of my platter, so that I can stick it. I'm just going to do a bit of marking so that it's visible for me. Now it's somewhere here, and I just need to put a cross mark so that I know the exact center of my board. Okay, now I have got my exact center, and now I need to start sticking this. So I will be starting with this one corner. And this is how I'm going to place it. Now, here is the interesting material. So this time I'm going to use my Fabricryl Mod Podge Gloss. Now this is a glossy Mod Podge. I have never ever used it. I've always used the matte finish Mod Podge or the decoupage glue, whatever I had, but not the glossy one. So I just thought of using this one for my video, and I really wanted to try that how this one give the after effect of drying, because whenever we say matte finish or the glossy finish, it's always the after effect of those products. It's not the look and feel of the product when it's wet, it's actually when it dries out. So I was really curious to know about this one. Okay, so now I will start applying this. First I'm going to take some bit of Mod Podge and on my flat brush directly, and I'm going to apply it on the center. Now here I will have to be little quick, because definitely I have to stick my paper pieces. So I'll start with the center area. Okay, I'm not going in any particular like position way. I'm just sticking it as much as I can, and I need to make sure that I don't have too much of gaps between my layers, because then it is going to definitely increase at the towards the end of the project. So I am just sticking these, and this is so fun. And I like, I always say, like, doing crafting is more of a therapy to me. It is more of creating something beautiful, creating something of your own, for your home, for your friends, for your family. And this is something which I absolutely love. Now one thing, I just feel that I am going to have too much of wastage with this paper cutting work, but I hope that it looks good so that it's totally worth it. Okay, so here I am almost done. Okay, so here I am done, and I'm just applying one coat of Mod Podge on the top of it. Now it's time for the second layer. Now I will start cutting again with my scissor and I will try to cut the pieces which I'm going to stick. You can do the cutting work in the starting also. I just wanted to avoid that cutting work because I just felt that I'll go very confused with the sizes of the papers because they are of almost same size and I did not wanted to goof up with that. So that is the only reason that I did not do the complete cutting work. I just did the border cutting work. Maybe I think I should have some more couple of cutouts here. Yes, I think this is good to go. Now this is a little tricky part that oops. I think having a bottle jar is much more easier. It's not the quality, it's just that maybe I feel using this way more comfortable. Okay, so here I'm starting with this second part and I will be sticking all my pieces here and I'm just trying to overlay one on the top of the other. Even if it doesn't go really on the top, that's absolutely fine. I am not trying to match the lines at all. I'm just trying to make sure that my circle comes properly. That's the most important thing here because I really wanted that way. So I just oops, I need to pull it off. Okay, so I'll put it here. As you can see that I'm not following the lines. I'm mostly trying to follow the circular pattern and I just want to make sure that everything sticks properly. One thing about this Mod Podge, I am loving this. This has some really nice and smooth texture which I am really liking. And yes, as I'm sticking my paper, I am also pressing down all the papers with my Mod Podge so that it sticks really well. And yes, it is done. Adding few more pieces and this is really good to go. I'm so excited, I'm so thrilled that I'm doing this video. Okay, so this is looking so cool. This is looking so amazing. So I'm just pressing down all the pieces a little more. Now it's time for my third circle and now as you see that my third circle is going to come on a little outer side and I, like I mentioned earlier, I have not picked up the exact size. It's the circle shapes, it's the random size, but almost of the same size. If you want, you can do this with the exact measurement. I did not want it to do it with the exact measurements. So okay, now cutting this. Okay, this is more comfortable way of cutting these papers. Okay, now first let me stick these and then I'll see if I need to cut more. I'll just keep those pieces aside. So I'll start with this area. I'm just trying to fill up the gaps and I'm just trying to make sure that I have good amount of spaces here and there. Maybe what you can do is, like I am applying my Mod Podge on my complete base, maybe you can just have it on your paper and stick it, but I had already started doing it that way, so I don't want to change the pattern of my sticking work. This is actually going to this might, because this is a glossy finish Mod Podge, so this might actually leave some mark there, so that's the reason I really don't want to change the pattern. But I think the better option would be to first apply the Mod Podge or your adhesive, whatever, your gel medium, your Mod Podge or your liquid adhesives on your paper and then you stick it. That way you will also save a lot on your adhesives too. This is really fun, and I'm happy that I picked the pink color because this is looking so nice, so subtle and beautiful. Okay, I need to cut few more pieces here. So I think two pieces and I will be done. So let me try having these two. First piece here and my second piece here, and this is just perfect. So I'm just taking up all the extra from my palette and I'm just doing a quick brush up to all my mosaic pieces. This is going to make sure that it sticks really well to my base. Now we need to move on to the fourth layer, and yes, I need to cut these also. So I'm just making sure that I have all the different pieces. Now the only reason is that this has a broader size, these have smaller size. I really did not want to mix those pieces. So if you can cut one circle at a time, keep it separately, then cut the other one, that will really make your work easier. So I am done with my cutting work. I think three, four more pieces, and I'm actually liking this as it is because this is already looking so nice and so beautiful, and I am actually liking the matte glossy finish also. So let's see at the end of the project I'll be able to know that did it really worked for me or not. So I'll just try to take out my Mod Podge from this point only. Now this is really fun, and I really want to thank all the people out there, those who had requested me so many times for mosaic decoupage project, and I'm glad you guys asked me. I am really enjoying this process of making a mosaic decoupage. Now this is one way of doing mosaic decoupage. Otherwise you get really nice printed papers in the market, you can have that, but I did this video because I wanted to show you that even with your plain pattern papers or the design papers what you have, you can actually create really nice mosaic patterns of your own. So it's not that every time you have to buy those expensive papers. Even with your simple design paper or the pattern paper, you can do it really well. So I'm almost done. I'm not sure, what do you think, that maybe I should have sticked all of them in a complete or like specific ratio and proportion, or this is good? I'm liking this one. I really don't have any complaints with this, but you can definitely pour in your suggestions. Just make sure whenever you're sticking it, you press it really well so that it sticks well to your project. End of the day, your cutting needs to be sticked properly on your base. That's the most important thing. I think I'll remove this one, stick it a bit close. Oops, stick it a bit closer. I just have this feeling that this glossy finish Mod Podge is drying a bit quickly. So I really don't know. Okay, and now this is done, and my last piece, maybe I'll cut it down a bit and then I'm going to stick this, and this looks perfect. Now I just need to add one touch up of my Mod Podge, and this looks really cool. I'm so proud of myself already. I'm already seriously feeling so proud of myself. Okay, this is done, and now it's time for the last round. And for the last round, I haven't done the cutting work, so I'm thinking whether to. Okay, let me have it. So I'll dip my brush in water, and can I have these papers? And can I use these cuttings and do the mosaic work? I'm not sure. I am not at all sure. So let me just try. Now this is really fun. I really don't want to trim those corners, because I already have so many left out pieces, and maybe I can use these and finish up this mosaic work. Just trim it this way and this way, and this is looking good to me now. Maybe I can add some more pieces here and there, and this will actually fill up. This will work good for me. I can have this piece here. I can have this piece here, and I'm so glad that this is actually working out for me. Okay, so now I'll take up another brush, because I've already dipped that in my bottle of water. Okay, so now I need to stick these. I'm just going to put a drop. Oops, I'm not liking this pump wala thing. I'm just having too much of mod podge everywhere. I'm loving the finish, but maybe I would suggest you to have a bottle so that you can easily keep it and easily use it. And if you have already this bottle, then maybe you can just have a small flat brush instead of having the bigger flat brushes, so that your sticking work becomes easy, like taking your mod podge becomes easy for you. One. This is really cool, because now I actually don't have much of wastage. So when I started this tutorial, I was really worried that I'm going to waste my paper, because usually I don't like wasting my papers at all. I try to avoid it as much as I can. Like if you have seen my video where I did a MDF cutout decoration work with my leftover decoupage pieces, I was absolutely proud of myself, because why to waste paper? This is so precious, this is so important, and we cut down so many trees for these papers, and there is so much of hard work when people have designed and decorated these papers, then why to cut it? Why? And that's the reason I absolutely love it when I don't waste my papers at all. Now as you can see, I have sticked my paper, and now I'm going to cut this. I'm going to hold this upside down, and I'm going to cut these papers, and I'm going to make sure that I'm a little gentle to my paper, because I have sticked them just now. So I can't be really, really tough to these paper cutouts. And yes, I'm still going to save these, because I am going to work on these. Like I will be using these papers. I might. Okay, so I'm done with my sticking work. Here and there I feel that I need to add some more mod podge. I'm doing that, but overall it's done. Okay, now I need to just add few papers on the corners, and I think that's absolutely fine to have these small cutouts. It's going to work. It is going to work. and it hardly matters if you are just having these small paper cutouts here and there, because mosaic is all about using your papers, how beautifully you can use it, how smartly you can use it. And yes, I am almost done. Oops. That's why I was wondering why I'm having so less of Mod Podge. Then I realized that I actually took up the small brush instead of the bigger size. And now here, again, I need to have this one. And just a dot. Maybe I can have this one here. Okay. This is done. Now I just need to press it well before cutting, because these are really small tiny edges. Let me close my Mod Podge 2. It's a matte finish. Oh no, it's a glossy finish Mod Podge, which I'm loving. Although I feel that I should have bought the bigger container, but as I was starting, so I bought the small pack. Oops. So 6x6 paper is more than sufficient for a 6x6 block. And this is looking absolutely stunning. I'm loving this one already so much. Now I let it dry and then I'll be back with the next process. Okay, now this splatter has dried out really well, and can you really see the glossy effect? It is actually shining, a bit shiny once it dries out. And now on the back side, it's completely plain, and I really can't leave that plain. So I'm using my script stamp and I'm going to make sure that I do it really well, and I'm going to do it upside down from both the sides so that it looks like one piece of art. And I'm actually liking this one. Maybe I can add some more stamping here and there. And yeah, I think this is good. Oh, this is looking so interesting. Now it's time to work on the front side. And before I do my the mosaic and the 3D work on it, I really want to have a good coat of varnish on this. Now why I want varnish before my 3D work on this, on my mosaic piece, because later on I won't be able to add my varnish to it. Whatever the 3D layer which I'm going to have, on that I don't want to do my varnish. So that's the reason I'm going to have good two coats of varnish on my complete project. Okay, I just realized that maybe I need to trim this area a little bit more. And yeah, rest of the areas are good. So here I'm applying my water-based varnish. As usual, I'm sharing all the links down in the video description box. You can check that. And I'm trying to give all the links to buy these products directly so that it's easier for you. And I really don't want you all to struggle the way I had struggled on finding each and every material, or the material which is really closer to this one. Now, can you really see? This looks really amazing. I'm so happy. I'm so happy that I tried this technique of mosaic decoupage, and this was really fun. Trust me, this was really fun. before starting, I was a little worried that, oh, this might take too much of time and this is going to be a very long process and how will it work, but it worked perfectly for me. And this actually gives a true essence of the mosaic decoupage, which is just fab, which is just fab. And I absolutely loved the design on these papers. I truly loved it, and this is looking really, really, really great now. Okay, so I am having just good coat of varnish and I'm just making my brushing work a bit more particular so that I don't leave too much of varnish on the edges of the paper. That is really important. Now I'm going to use my heat gun to speed up the drying process. Can you see this is looking so amazing, and I absolutely love this one. Now I'm going to have good 2 coat of varnish on the back side also, because of course this is a surface which is going to touch my table base or my floor base, and I really want this to have a secured a good varnish base so that I can easily clean it up. So whenever you use varnish, I have never ever tried washing my MDF products, but I always clean them with my wet wipe or my damp clothes, and they are really, really, really good to go. And that's what I love with the process of decoupage, that you, when you make it, you can actually use it. So when I started crafting, my only motto was that I'm creating, but will I be able to use it? And that is something which I have been following till date, that if I'm making something, I really should be able to use it, or if I'm gifting it to someone, or if anyone is buying something for me, they should be able to use it. So the utility part has to be taken care of. So of course I understand that with these kind of projects, like, some people expect to wash them, but I don't think you can wash it. Like, I've done a tutorial on video on how to clean your decoupage plates, where I had actually shown you like what kind of blunders can happen and all those stuff. So here I'm done with my varnish work, and here I'm done with my 2 coats of good varnish work on my complete project, and now it's time to move on to the next step. Here is the fun in the final part. So in this cup I have my resin and my hardener. I have not mixed it yet. I am mixing it, and This is the same ratio what I had shown you in one of my videos. So if you have not checked that video, I'm sharing the link down. You can check that tutorial where I had actually used my resin and hardener, and I had shown you that how to mix it really well and what is the ratio what you should take. Now, like I had mentioned in that video also, that for each resin and hardener brand, the set, the ratios are different, so you need to follow that. But the basic thumb rule is of 10:4, which I have actually shown in detail in that tutorial. So do check that video, and that is actually going to make your work really really easy. Now you can have any of the wooden sticks or any scrap sticks to mix this and use this, but I have this one from the packed food what you get delivered. So this was an extra piece and I thought of using this one. Very 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 important thing before starting with your resin work, you need to make sure that it sticks, that it has been mixed really well and there are no bubbles in this, because if there will be bubbles, it is going to come to your project. So now you can see it is really clear and it has mixed well, but still you need to just keep on mixing it for a good 2 to 3 minutes. Now I know you can see some toothpicks on my table, and this is something which I have picked up because I will be needing something really pointy and with a smaller area to spread my resin. So okay, now I will zoom in the camera. Okay, now this is my base, this is my resin, and now I'm going to apply this. I'll just put a drop of resin. I'll clear up the extra with my napkin. So you have to be really really careful when you are working with this. I'll keep my watermark here. Okay, now can you really see, I've just put up a dot, and with my toothpick I'm going to spread it. Now working with resin is a little tricky. It spreads if you just over pour it, so you need to be really really careful about that. But the really best part is that you get good 45 minutes to work on your project, which is quite a good time. So I'm just putting a dot of resin, just a drop of resin, and I'm going to make sure that I don't overdo with pouring of my resin, and I do it really well. So yes, let me try with the second one. So I'm going to start with one side of my plate and then I'm going to move on to the other step. Just make sure you pick up the stuff to spread these, which you really don't want, because once you have used your resin on these objects, then you can't really use them. It will dry out really hard, which you can't remove at all. I need to put one more dot here. Maybe I should have taken the ice cream stick only, because this is actually falling down very 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 quickly. So now I'll just speed up the process of adding my resin to my mosaic decoupage, and this is really really fun, and you need to be a little patient, and yes, it is going to turn out really good. One very 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 important tip, that whenever you're doing your resin work, do keep your plain tissues or hand towel really handy, so that if anything just smudges, you can clean it up immediately, and that is actually going to save your project. So while I'm doing the speedy work, you can see that here and there I have used my tissue paper, not the wet wipe, just the tissue paper, or any cotton hand towel will also do. But tissue papers are more better because you can just use it and then throw it, because they are of no use after that. So immediately with that, I'm just cleaning up anything extra which has dropped in on my platter or my base. So that becomes really, really easy and handy. So this is how I actually filled up the complete areas. Somewhere I had to add more of resin, so actually I had to do 2 coats of resin. So what I realized is that when I did with my first coat,
And when I shifted, I was actually, when I was coming down to the bottom area of my platter, I realized that the upper in the upper part, the edges are shrinking up. It is actually drying up with one center dome in the on the each paper. So it was basically the edges did not got the complete raisin in an equal part. So that's the reason I had to add 2 coat of raisin, only spreading it on the edges. And like I have already told you that raisin can be used within 45 to 50 minutes, which is a really good time. So I actually got ample of time for the 6x6 platter to smudge it, to spread it really well, to give a second coat and to mix it really well. And this was super, super, super easy. So yes, one more thing, that when I did my second mixing, yes, I had to do 2 mixing. So on my second mix of raisin, there were so many of bubbles which I could see, but I had to just whip it really, really, really well, and all the bubbles were gone. But I had to be a little gentle with the whipping, because you need to be really, really gentle with the raisin, because you just can't do it very fast. You have to be a little slow and gentle with your raisins. One very, very important thing which I always wanted to know, that how much amount of raisin is required for this much amount of platter. Now that I have made this video, I could realize that for this 6x6 inch platter, and the amount of work, the papers I have taken, the amount of raisin what I required was approximately 7 ml of raisin, and accordingly the ratio of hardener. So first when I mixed my raisin, it was 5 ml. In total, it was 5 ml of raisin with the hardener. And then towards the end, I realized that I am running out of raisin mix. Then I had to again redo the mix. And that was approximately 2 ml of raisin and the hardener as per that ratio. So in total, what I have used here is around 7 ml of raisin with hardener, which was just perfect for this kind of platter. I was not left with anything in the midway. So this is a ratio which I think is really important, because raisin and hardeners and all your craft supplies are really important. So you really need to know that how much exactly the raisin you need. Yes, of course, there are many ideas, like I have even shown in my previous videos also, that if you are left over with your extra raisin mix, you can definitely make pendants and accessories and everything. But of course, every time we can't just keep on making the excessive raisin. So this ratio was perfect for me, around 7 ml is something which you can consider for this 6x6 inch platter. And you've already seen that how much paper I've used. It is just the perfect 6x6 inch paper. And yes, of course, I had few of the scrap border area, so you can chuck that part. So with this, my tutorial is done, and I really hope that I could solve your queries about the mosaic decoupage with raisin, and I hope you'll enjoy this tutorial. Yes, this was a quite lengthy video, but I thoroughly enjoyed making this one. I am sharing few pictures of my final product, which it like how it looks after drying at the end. Do check that. Also, I am sharing all the supplies link down in the description box. I am also adding the links to buy them in USA and in India, so that it's easier for you. If I don't get the link of the exact supplies, I'm going to try and find out, and I'll try to add up the links of as closer product what I can get. But then of course you will have to explore maybe. So yes, with this my tutorial is done. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.